Al-Imam al-Nawawi, just to start with, he is not Ash'ari. Yes, he was influenced by the Ash'ari at his time, but he was not Ash'ari. He had made a treatise, a booklet, in the Harf wa Sawt, al-Harf, which is that the Quran, which is Allah spoke it, Allah Azza wa spoke it with a letter and a sound. When you say this, you are Salafi straight away. You are not Ash'ari. He had made a booklet in that, which is just about 2 months and few days before he died. In that book, you could see that he backed off from those statements which he had adopted. He did not write them himself. That would look that they are statements which are inclined to the Ash'ari madhab. Our Sheikh Mashhur Hafidhahullah, and I have taken that from him directly when I used to go to his class, in Sharh al-Imam, Sahih al-Imam Muslim, Imam al-Nawawi, called Sharh Sahih al-Imam Muslim, Imam al-Nawawi, in that Sharh, and still the Sheikh is going through it, but not during the COVID-19. In that Sharh, he came across the Kitab al-Iman. Kitab al-Iman, there are things there to do with the Ahadith of al-Sifat. And Sheikh also, he has a book, which is Ta'qibat ala Sharh al-Imam al-Nawawi, that is Sharh Sahih al-Muslim. That is, the Ta'qibat means commentary onto some of the explanations of Imam al-Nawawi to Sahih Muslim. So he made a book as a commentary in which he had refuted some of the mistakes that Imam al-Nawawi had been through it. But our Sheikh Mashhur Hafidhahullah, he says with an open mouth that he is not an Ash'ari. A'udhu billah, he's not an Ash'ari. And in his book of Ijaz al-Sifat, which is the one that makes him like inclined, he had quoted sayings. He did not make these sayings. He quoted from Al-Khatib al-Baghdadi. He quoted from other scholars. And he put them there, but it's not his own words. And in that booklet, which I have said, Al-Harf wa Sawt, he had negated all of that. And he went back to the Madhab al-Salafi. And the best of proof of this is Al-Imam Al-Ala ibn al-Attar, which is his student, whom he had been his shadow to such an extent that the people used to call him Mukhtasar al-Nawawi. Mukhtasar means like abridged Nawawi. It's not the big Nawawi, this is small Nawawi. Small version of it. Mukhtasar al-Nawawi. He used to follow him like his shadow. And he never assigned himself or attached himself to any scholar at this time more than he attached himself to the Imam Abu Zakaria, Yahya ibn Sharaf al-Nawawi al-Dimashqi rahmatullahi alayhi. So in there, Al-Ala, he had made a book. And that book in which he had shown that the Salafiyya is the Haqq. And he had shown in that book the mistakes of those who are on the madhab of the Ash'ari. And it's called Al-I'tiqad al-Khalis min al-Shak. Okay? So the book called Al-I'tiqad al-Khalis, that is from the Shak. I'tiqad al-Khalis, the pure creed, which is empty from doubt. That's the name of the book. In which Al-Ala ibn Attar, rahimahullah, he had stated that the correct madhab is the madhab al-Salaf, and the mistakes which are the madhab al-Ash'ara has. And this Imam, he is a student of Imam al-Nawawi. That's a very great proof that Imam al-Nawawi is not an Ash'ari, as the people say. Another issue that is, we could as well, Imam ibn Hajar al-Asqalaanee, they also attribute him to be as from the Ash'ari. No, he's not from the Ash'ari. Yes, there are some of his statements in Fath al-Bari, in which our Sheikh Abdulaziz ibn Baz had made elaboration on it, that it has a hint, okay, that is to do with ta'wil, tafweed, to some of the sifat, that is to reinterpret, not to come to the real meaning of it. But there are statements there, when he goes longer and longer in explaining Imam ibn Hajar al-Asqalani, you could see very clearly that Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani, he is championing the madhab of the Salaf, and he is also in following the same path of Imam Ahmad, and after that the Imam Ibn Taymiyyah rahmatullahi alayh. But you need to know as well the time of Imam Ibn Hajar, it was the Asr al-Mamalik, and the state was where the capital was Al-Qahira, Cairo, and all the provinces of the Muslims, they were actually assigning themselves to that capital. And in there, there was a big attack, just like it is today, onto the Madhab al-Salafi, especially on Ibn Taymiyyah. SubhanAllah, it said the history repeats itself. Allahul Musta'an. History repeats itself. So there was a big attack on the any person. So if you they've smelled from you Ibn Taymiyyah, you're finished. That's why Ibn Hajar Asqalani, he would never declare anything that would attribute himself to Ibn Taymiyyah. Yet, as I said, in his prolonged text, which is that only the scholars will know, you could see that he is following of the Salaf Madhab, rahmatullahi alayhi. Well, I'll tell you what, Imam Abu al-Hasan al-Ash'ari, he himself, at the end of the days, he had made the book of Al-Ibana, which the Ash'ari, they don't really attribute it to him, in which he had said, so Al-Maqarat al-Islamiyyin as well, Ahl al-Thagr, in which he had declared he's gone off from the Madhab al-Ash'ari that he had introduced himself, and then later on, I am on the Imam Ahmad Madhab, which is Madhab al-Salaf. The Madhab, they read the Quran and they read the Sunnah, and that they will not do alteration. يُثْبِتُ مَا أَثْبَتَهُ اللَّهُ وَيَنْفِي مَا يَنْفِيهِ اللَّهُ. That is, they will affirm what Allah and His Messenger had affirmed for Himself, for Allah Azza wa Jal, and they would negate what Allah and His Messenger had negated. They will not go further than that.